So I've started training with Rambaa at his gym in Pattaya after my morning trainings at Pyeongchang. So this is our second day training together that you're watching right now. And he put on a belly pad. He didn't wear that the first day, and he wanted me to kind of work on, as he's coming in, just really slam him with knees and create space that I needed. So I'm getting ready to fight Loma, who is pretty much the best clinch fighter at my weight and one of the best fighters in the world. And I've fought her 3 times, but I've never won, and she's just so smart and tricky. So we're trying to figure out, how do I get ready for Loma? And here he's showing how to use your hand, especially when you're wearing a glove. You push right on someone's nose, and in the glove you can actually pinch it. You can pinch someone's nose closed. He told me a couple of times, don't be polite about it. Like, really, really push in the face. But so Kevin came up with the idea of training with Rambaa to get ready for Loma. And we weren't even sure he would do it. One, because he's this amazing, legendary trainer, and training one-on-one in clinching is kind of not necessarily something that adult men will do, especially because I'm a woman. But he totally embraced it. He's been so generous with me. It probably helps that Kevin comes with me. But he is just really, really giving me a lot. And a lot of people, here he's showing where to push again. Don't push on the shoulder, you push on the inside of the elbow to create leverage. Like that. So here I'm creating framing and trying to turn him a little bit. But he's been really amazing. He basically kicks my ass for like 35, 40 minutes every morning. He's giving me really, really intense, like, he has bashed my legs so bad. And that's generosity. That's really amazing that he's helping me like that. So this is us just starting out. So my energy's pretty good with his belly pad. But you can see it's getting harder for me as we go, because he's just slowly increasing the pressure. It's like boiling water. The temperature just keeps going up. So you can see he's just coming in, and he just wants me to respond. He's not really doing a lot of his, like, turns and interruptions. He's not making it that hard for me yet, but slowly increasing it. And you can see that I'm actually creating way too much space, like more space than I need. My hips should be in more. And I keep putting myself in the ropes, especially on this day. I was like a spider. I just could not help it. I was in the ropes all the time. And once he starts kicking my legs, I just kind of retreat to them. I was a little bit better at it today. So here he's showing, again, to go to the inside of the elbow to break that lock and have more control. So here I kind of forget myself, and I'm not going to the inside of his arm there, so I got stuck. You can see my hand is on his bicep, which is why I can't break out. His hand is on my elbow. And again, my hips are too far back. You bring your hips back for the knee, but then you need to close it again immediately. This is super exhausting, this kind of work, but it's really, really good because it forces you to relax under that kind of pressure. He's got a really good lock. He's spent a lot of years as an MMA fighter, so his locks are really strong and kind of choky. There, so he's complaining to me that I was pushing on him, but I wasn't being mean. Here he's saying when you wear the glove, you use either your hand part to pinch the face, or you use the part that's taped, like the actual wrist, and just slice it across someone's face. I've actually had cuts on my face from the tape before, and that's what he's saying to do. He's like, everybody does it. So, right there, he was explaining to me that when I have a dominant position, when I'm being really strong, you don't have to push the face. It's when he's being really strong, when the person that you're fighting starts to get control, that's when you push the face. So don't let go of your good grip to push the face. Only push it when the person that you're going against has a good position, like that. And then he gets my arm stuck. He starts kneeing my legs. It's so painful when he does it. I'm just trying to jump and do anything to get out of this position, but it's a little far gone. So here he's trying to show me you knee and then block out of the knee. So knee first, block. And then you switch. Yeah, so he's saying that you can alternate between these two. Knee, block, knee, block. So there I'm controlling his arm a little bit better with the inside of the elbow, but I really should be pushing it off to a different angle. So there he didn't like it because I kneed, came down, and then blocked. You go into the block from the knee. He's saying it's too slow if you come down first.
Don't go down.
Alright, so here we get more into the just free flow clinching. Rambaa explained to me that when he was a fighter, he's a knee fighter, but he was often a lot shorter than his opponents, and so he couldn't get his knees up to people's rib cages and stuff without really tiring himself out. So he knees the legs a lot. He knees my legs a lot. But it's really useful in changing position and in just causing pain so that it weakens the person that you're kneeing or that you're clinching with. He's a very active clincher, which is very difficult for me. I'm more of a locker. I'm more comfortable locking and doing damage from there, but he keeps moving, which is something I need to learn how to do. It makes it really difficult when he just keeps flowing, because I kind of can't think that fast, which is why you're just supposed to feel it. I should be pushing his face there, the way that he taught me. There, so he's happy with that. I should be moving out, though. So again, I keep putting myself in the corner, and then I'm just kind of stuck there. That's him being generous, pulling me out of the corner. He could have just destroyed me right there. My legs are already sore from the day prior, which we didn't film. But so this is already cumulative damage on my legs, and every time he touches them, it's pretty painful. But this day, I figured out that I can do it back to him, except when I'm stuck there. See, I should just be jamming into his thigh there. It's always been my ethic to put up training videos where I'm still learning, not where I look awesome, so you guys get to see me get my ass kicked. I'm pretty much just trying to survive this. But see, putting my hips back from the pain, I put my hips back, and then I'm just kind of screwed, so...
Fish body, baby, fish body.
It kind of gets to the point where, like, the pain isn't going to stop, so you just kind of have to, like, fight through it. I'm a little bit floppy at the moment, like, not fighting through it super well. See my hips back, going into the ropes. And Rambaa's awesome, so he punishes me for it. It's a saying in Thai, no pain, no understand. You fix things faster when it hurts. So I'm just trying to do something here. Hopping would probably get me out of that. So there I'm trying to stand up more, but at a weird distance. I should be standing up here. You can see I'm bending out. I tried to trip him there and it totally didn't work. That hurts. He does this thing where when you put your foot down, he hits the inside of your thigh with his foot. He calls it his jab. And it takes like three of them before it's so painful that you just don't want more. But there's kind of nothing you can do about it. You just got to keep that leg up because he hits it when it goes down. So he's happy with the power of those knees. I'm just trying to stagnate his lock there with my arm up. If I put my hips in there, I'd be in a better position, but here I'm just kind of exhaustedly wrestling with him, which it doesn't really help me. See, he's much more relaxed and comfortable to flow than I am. Because my hips are back, I have limited a lot of my positions. I can't really transition that well. He can do whatever he wants.
Stand up, baby. You're getting limp.
And since I've already put myself in the ropes, my options are pretty limited. There, he's just pulling back. That's all he's doing. And because my hips were already back, he can do that. If my hips had been in, it would have been much harder for him to do that. You can see that when I'm scared, I'll just admit it and say I'm scared, I get way more still. If I was moving around more, it would be harder for him to do all of the things that he's doing. He knew how much that hurt.
Stand up, Sylvie.
You can tell from the sounds he makes how much he knows he's hurting me. And see, I'm just hanging out on the ropes, so he can just do all of that. He's really good at that. He knees the leg and then the body. He says he does that because if you just knee up top, people can turn you. They just wait for it. But if you knee the leg first, it both hides your timing and distracts them. I've never been kicked as someone's bringing their leg back in from being put out the ropes before. So I tried to be tough and just take those, but they kind of hurt.
Stand up, Sylvie.
They're putting my hips in a little bit better, but then they fall back out, and now I'm like leaning on the ropes, and he can actually just push me into them. I have no way out now. My right arm could wrap around if I used the inside of his elbow the way he taught me. There, trying to do that a little bit. But I need to make a power move out of it, not like a floppy, let me try to like drape myself this way.
Stand up, Sylvie.
So here I try to lock him, but I'm leaning against the rope, so my leverage is not too great, and he gets out. And that little shake that he's doing makes it impossible for me to lock him. Do that. It's really good. They look so delicate on film. They're so painful in person. The pain of them is what's causing me to back up into the ropes so much. You really just gotta, like, bite down and move forward, try to stay in the center of the ring a little bit. He knows how much that hurts. He's pointing at it.
Stand up, Sylvie.
And right back into the ropes. This is really good for me because as a clincher, I want to clinch, and he's doing things that's making me stand back, so I'm not clinching. And just taking a lot of damage. That hurt.
Stand up slowly.
That's right on the muscle.
You're flat footed. Come on.
So you'll see I'll take a step in, like I'll be brave and take a step in, but then I immediately take a step out and he tags me when I do that. So now I'm in, but I'm not being tough about it. I'm just trying to slowly find my way to a position instead of like being quick. Now my hips are back. So I'm getting a few knees in, but I can't really angle myself. So that forced him to change position, which is good. But so now I need to be pushing his face better than that. Jaidi is like good-hearted. He's like, don't be good-hearted. Like really push someone in the face. Don't be polite about it. Like that, yeah. So when I'm teaching people how to clinch, I always tell them, like I'm good at keeping my elbows in so that people can't swim in, and I always tell them don't keep trying to do the same angle if it's not working. Like, if you can't get your right arm in, don't keep trying to get your right arm in. Do something on the left. And that is exactly the advice I need to give myself when clinching with Rambaa. Like, I tell other people, and then I don't do it because I'm so overwhelmed by the pressure he's putting on me. So there I'm trying to solve the leg kick by popping in and not following there. Again, that looks delicate, and he's definitely pulling it, but God, that hurts. Buckles you. And you can definitely do this in a fight, and in the time of a fight, it's gonna damage the legs. So there I'm getting really flat-footed and just putting my ass into the ropes, so I'm actually bent already. I have nowhere to go. So you can... Diesel and I called it... He didn't call it this, but he imitated, like, a floppy body, and so I called it fish body. And he was complaining to me about how I'm strong in the clinch, but then my body kind of goes all wiggly, and what's happening right now is exactly that. Like, my body just kind of bends and gets all mushy, even though I'm being really strong in my arms. And so you really have to stand up straight. Like, you want to posture yourself like a statue or something. Like, you want to embody strength all the way through. Getting up on your toes is a huge deal for that. I just got my hand behind my back. I'm got nothing. I got nothing. Thank you. I think I need to be faster with my teeps. The way that he's catching them, I just need to be a little bit more forceful. I think that more than anything, putting me through this kind of, like, torture and pain, he's just trying to get the fight energy to be consistent and to keep going. I have it in moments, but again, the floppiness and the fear and the kind of, like, wilting, that's all gotta go. It's just gotta be... See how steady his energy is all the time? He's the one putting all the pressure on. But even when I get something good in on him, he kind of poker faces it really well. So I have my hand in a good position, but then I don't use it. And now I'm stuck. I have no leverage. I can't be strong from that position. So I should be hopping more, or turning, or just kind of like... being more forceful. You can see I'm already bent now. So those pushes aren't bad that I'm doing, but you have to do something with them. You can't just shove someone. I need to shove them for the off balance and then follow them. So see how he stands his ground and pretty much only takes space? And I'm giving him space all the time, backing up a lot, putting myself in the ropes so he can do that. and because I'm kind of wilting from the pain and the pressure, you can see how easy it is for him to just... move me around. If I were being a little bit more stoic about it and like hard and strong, it would look different and then it might feel different for me. When my arm gets stuck like that, kind of against my own throat, there's not a lot you can do.
Don't go dead fish. You lose the fight.
And when someone points out to you what you might try to be better, like try something different, don't respond the way I just did, like Kevin said. Just try it. Take "I can't" out of your vocabulary for sure. trying.
At the very least, bounce. Don't go
dead
fish.
That was a good knee. I was happy with that. You can see the, like, the position of my hand. You can see how screwed I am already. Now he's using his chin to, like, pin my head. And now both my arms are folded over my face.
Stop backing up.
Applauding himself, basically knocked me out right there. So he waits for my leg to go down, and that's when he kicks it. There. You can see I'm like trying to use my energy and I'm shoving him off, but for what? Like, what is that shove for if I don't do anything after it? So you can see my arms also are like down by my sides now. They're not even up in a guard anymore. just by putting them up in a guard, because that's how I feel when I have more energy. I might feel more energy. Just fake the postures and guard anyway, because damn. There, a little bit better. Standing in better, at least. A little flinchy.
Stop backing up, Sylvie. You're on the ropes the whole time. I was trying to teach you.
So you can see I'm in distance to grab him for the clinch, and I'm not even grabbing him for the clinch. Like, I've basically wilted already. It takes incredible mental energy to just keep going when it's this painful, but you gotta take those extra steps.
That's better, baby.
You gotta take those risks and let that happen. It's better than wilting. So there. I got him right on the muscle. And I didn't even feel bad about it. I said I'm not even sorry right there. But he said that because he hasn't fought in a long time, his legs aren't conditioned anymore. So I don't know if him bashing up my legs is trying to condition them, or if it's just, like, mental toughness. But I went back after his leg, and his eyes got really wide. He was surprised I did that. See, but he's now showing me what you can do to protect that leg, which I'm not doing. I got him in the leg again. It's so painful, guys. This is not a, like... This dude does not overact pain. And my leg is so swollen. Oh. He said he wasn't ready for it. There was no warning.
What did he say?
He's saying you only have to hit a little bit, but on the right spot. But you can see my confidence is a little better now that I've hurt him. But see how he controls, like, with his scrunching his shoulder and pulling my arm down? I cannot get that arm in. I nailed him in the groin there. That's not good. So he's showing that when you knee up high, someone can wait for it and just turn you, which is why he knees the leg first. So he goes leg, then body. And I think, actually, now that his energy is, like, trying to protect himself but also get a point back, rather than just being a dick and, like, hitting my leg so much, I think that my energy feeds off of his aggressive energy differently than feeding off of his, like, playful, I'm just gonna bash your legs energy. Which is something I need to think about and learn. I'm on my toes a little bit better, which is why he can't turn me there. But now I'm getting on my heels. And now that I'm on my heels, I can't do anything. He's a little bigger than I am. Yeah, I got his leg again.
Hey,
So you can see he takes that space with his hips in order to knee, but then he closes it back up, whereas I'm just leaving that space all the time. And I pretty much need every bit of strength that I have to go against him. I'm stuck. So by putting my ass back, I'm taking away probably like 30% of my power, if not more. Just putting my hips in would look really different right there. So that I figured out by teeping his front leg, I could then kick his back leg. It's like the kneeing to the thigh, kneeing to the body. It's a little bit of a distraction.
Hop, Sylvie, hop, something. Energy.
Badass. In my highlight reel for how awesome I am. You can see he's just using his forearm there. Like he's not even using his hand for the grip. And then my foot is between his feet, so I can't do anything. You have to get a wider stance. There's a baby to the left of Kevin that was like way into this whole thing. He's squealing every time I got thrown down. That was beautiful the way he grabbed and then immediately swung his head to the side. It's very smooth. I'm getting bashed. I was trying to give it back to him for a minute there, but then not as much. Alright, so then we continue on, and I'm trying to have a little bit more movement, rather than slowing down and looking terrified all the time. So here I'm actually just mirroring him a little bit, just going after his legs and trying to teep a little bit more, rather than trying to plow in and clinch, which is probably what I should have been doing. Here I'm trying to bounce to change position, but my head was bent so that my chin was up.
Hop,
you want to keep your head down for your angles and leverage. See, now that my head's down, I have a little bit more leverage.
Energy.
So I don't know what I'm doing with my right arm. It's useless. There we go.
What are you doing? Show energy.
So with that hop in, I should hop all the way in until my leg is basically on him.
Oh,
I'm tired enough now that I'm a little bit more relaxed, which is helping. The thing about clinching, and especially going against people like Rambaa, who are really tricky, they make you really tense, because you're always anticipating pain or like being turned or whatever. Like, very tricky fighters make you very tense, and the trick is to relax against them, which is really, really hard to do. My exhaustion at this point is helping a little bit. He's like, oh, sorry, because he accidentally hit my knee, as though all of these fucking leg kicks are not way more painful than that.
No. Don't put it down. Hop in.
Oh, guys. So painful.
Don't put it down.
Kevin's like, don't put your leg down, but Rambaa threw my leg down. I didn't put it down. He put it down.
Hop in, baby. Don't go back. Oh, go forward. Forward.
Oh, you can see the difference, too, between his kicks and my kicks. Oh, it's so awful, guys.
Go forward, Sylvie.
It's so bad.
Hop in. All the way. All the way. Come on, go forward. Go in.
It's one of these things where it's going to hurt either way, so just take the space, man. Don't back up.
Hop in. Clinch him. Hop in, clinch him. Hop in. Sylvie.
Kevin's advice is really good right now. It's totally what I need to do. But if you want to translate it to what it sounds like when you're being beat on like this, it's like, grab the stove, Sylvie. Grab the stove. Jesus. I know I should. But it's kind of hard to get my head around it. That's because my ass is back. There, little bit. And I don't know what my arms are doing there. I've got nothing. Double outside, not locking. So here I should be bouncing and pulling him backwards, but because my back's against the ropes, I got nowhere to go. So you can drag him along the ropes, like that, a little bit. Back. No. All right. Note for later.
Is that your first tap? No,
that little girl tap me. I was in a sparring class at Tiger Schulman's years ago with my friend Robin, and they made us do grappling, and I went against this like 10-year-old girl who put me in an armbar within like 20 seconds. So that was my second tap ever that you guys have seen right there.
Yeah. Don't go back, baby. Come on, get up. Yeah, you can.
He knows. The whole leg locks up. You like can't really put weight on it.
Don't go back. Don't
and
go
he
back.
Hit it again. He's like, just a little bit. You just hit it a little bit. Yeah.
Same.
He has a sakyant on his thigh. If you go right below it, that's where you should hit him, right there. He's like, it hurts. Yeah, I know.
Ooh.
See his posture as he comes in? That's what I need to do. God, what a nightmare to fight he must have been. Put your ass in the ropes, and this is what this is what happens. Namkabuan has this amazing fight where they go out of the ropes, and he like jumps over the rope, comes back in, and hits the guy before the ref even looks. My roll back in is not that badass, but that's my version.
Nice, baby. I know.
This guy came to watch and was very impressed by how I kept going despite how badly I was getting my ass kicked. Pull, pull, pull! Oh, God. See how when he's coming in, he doesn't really stop, and I do, like, take a step and stop. This is the thing, is that, like, he's kind of doing little fakes and stuff, but ultimately he's hitting me with the same things over and over and over again, which shows the importance of just the movement. He hits you like right in your bladder with those. It really hurts. It's like right below the belly button. And I'm a little flaily. He's like, my leg hurts. Whatever, Rambaa. Alright, so this is my third day with Rambaa. Gum is to like kind of bend over. So he's saying stay upright and you put your hips back in order to knee. But then you stand up again. You don't just come in like a shrimp. Master K used to say, you are not a shrimp. So just making his pad tighter. So he's like, stand upright. And then you make the space with your hips for the knee. Alright, so here he's showing how to pull to off balance before throwing your knee. So he's like, pull first, then throw the knee. He's being really nice and giving me some instruction first so that I can actually do things before just killing me for the rest of the session. So he's saying it's better to actually yank twice. You don't have to do it as hard. And he's saying that if you just pull once, people can kind of resist it. They still have balance. So if you yank once, he can kind of hold. But if you yank twice, he can't catch his balance. This is truth, guys. This is total truth. You do two little yanks and people generally can't resist it. So I'm trying to stand up more. So he's saying, like, sometimes do one pull and sometimes do two pulls. You just don't do the same thing all the time. So there, making space with my hips for the knee and then trying to stand up again to close it. This is like clinch 101, but it's the kind of thing that you forget, and when you're under a lot of pressure, you end up just with your ass back the whole time and you can't really do anything. So getting up on my toes there, that's making a big difference, and that's because my head is up. Like, he was not like, get on your toes. He said, stand up straight, and I go up on my toes to stand up straight. So here he's showing how to use your shoulder to pinch and get someone's arm off of you. So when they've already grabbed you, you pinch your shoulder and rotate a little bit. But you have to stay close. If you don't stay close, it won't pinch properly. And you can see I'm fighting to keep his arms off with my shoulders and my neck better than I have been. Bit is close in Thai. So he's like, close your shoulder and your neck.
Step in, baby, not out.
So if I step back, he can keep holding. But if you stay really close, see how it just pushes me out?
Forward though, but not out, not away.
If you pinch your shoulder hard enough when you rotate, it actually hurts the forearm of the person grabbing. You can see I'm like pushing his grip off better than I have been previously, just because it's been brought up again and put into the mix. This is why going over basics is really important. Here I'm starting to get a little bit more flat-footed again. Stand up, stand up. So he's like, if you try to pinch it off and it doesn't come off, then you just swim your arm in and push at the elbow. So, again, he's like, don't keep trying to do something that's not working, just switch it. So if you can't get it off by pinching your shoulder, you swim inside and push it off. It's important to keep changing. Like I said earlier, from the day before, he switches position all the time. He's a very fast clincher, which makes him a nightmare to deal with. The more stagnant you are, even if you've got a lot of strength in your grip, the easier you are to deal with. If you keep moving, people can't think, they can't get to their basics or what they're used to. So there, he wants me to hook over his arm. He's really good with that one. When he hooks your arm, he yanks on it and turns you. That's really painful, the way he does it. He pinches right near your elbow, and it's painful. And then as I was turning, I was kind of yanking down, and you saw that his body kind of flattened out a little bit.
I like the reverse of the inside move on it.
Okay, so he's like, blian, blian, which is change. So he's like, just try everything. Like, just keep swimming and moving. So I was doing all right while we were drilling. And now he puts actual pressure on me. It's hilarious when he says sorry because he does something unintentional, because it never hurts as much as the stuff he's intentionally doing. He's like, you do good, I do good. I also do things.
That's good.
I So I'm pinching my neck better than I was the day before, for sure. I'm a little bit pushing with my shoulders, so I'm got my hips back, but I'm putting my hips back in and yanking them a little bit better. So here I should be turning and yanking. Anytime there's a moment of standstill, that's when you should be pulling and yanking. And so even though we just worked on this stuff with pinching my shoulders and swimming and going to the inside of his arm and all of these things, it's very hard to access those things when there's this much pressure on you. So I'm going flat-footed again, my hips are going back, all of the things that make it difficult to do those things that we were drilling because of the pressure. So I always said that when I first started Muay Thai, I didn't think I was going to fight. But after about a year, I realized I didn't really know anything unless I could do it under pressure. And that's basically what Rambaa is working with me on in our privates, is that he puts a lot of pressure on me. He puts a lot of pressure. And so whatever skills I think I know or have, you don't really know them until you can do them under pressure. Like here I should be able to get out of that doing exactly what we did in that drill at the beginning, but I can't think of it. I'm getting my hair in his mouth. He's saying I should shave my head like him so that I don't get hair in his mouth. So if I was pushing on his face like we did the day before, that would be a different story. And then here, now that I've got his arm, I should be yanking him in that direction. But
get off the rope, baby. Get off the rope.
Oh, look at his face. You can see in my hands and in my arms that I lack the tension. Not tense, like using muscles for no reason, but the tension to use strength against him. So I only have one speed. Like, you need to go slow, slow, fast, slow, slow, fast. But right now I only have one speed, and it's basically slowing way down and becoming stagnant to try to give myself time to think. You gotta think while you're moving. The move comes to you based on what you did to get out of whatever he's doing.
Off the rope. Off the rope.
So, because I spent so much time on the ropes the day before, I was trying really hard to, like, stay off the ropes, stay in the middle of the ring a little bit more.
Off the rope, baby.
So I actually have a decent position there to try to turn him, and I couldn't quite figure it out.
Off the rope.
So I've got the framing, and I'm a little bit on my toes, but then I'm not yanking on him. You can see how he has these quick movements, and mine are all very stagnant. I'm trying to swim, but I'm not jerking on him or anything. My hips are in a little bit better. But I'm creating, like, no problems for him. And he can feel how stuck I am.
Make a move.
So there, I've got control of his arm, and then I'm not turning him.
Jump something. He's thrown. Make a move.
So Kevin's like, take the risk. He's going to throw you or hit you or anything anyway. So take the risk. Throw something. Figure out where that balance is.
Be thrown. It doesn't matter. Get off the rope. Get off the rope.
So you can see I'm on my heels, like leaning on my heels. It's okay. So he's saying turn here. That didn't take a lot of energy right there. So he's like, you grab the neck all the time. So he's like, it's the same. I think I have to grab the neck to turn, but he's like, it's the same everywhere. Look at his feet as he turns. He's saying it's the same, it's the same.
So strong, baby, mentally.
Oh, good. My head went down. He's saying it's because he's big, but I think if I had had my hips in, it wouldn't have followed. So I'm getting a little bit flat-footed again. But I am stepping outside of him better than I have been.
Get off the rope, baby. Get off the rope. Off the rope. Stand up. Jump. Off the rope. Off the rope.
So you, it's like turning a giant wheel. You want your arms to move together. So he's saying if you try to turn him towards his front leg, he has a lot of balance. If you turn him towards his back leg, he's going to spin. Standing up a little bit better. Trying to long clinch here a little bit.
Move, make your move.
He's saying turn, turn, turn. He's saying in Muay Thai, this is really good. And that's what Loma does, so it's really good to be thrown a bunch. Because she's going to be throwing me a bunch.
Get off the rope. Make your move fast, Sylvie.
So there I off-balanced him just enough that his turn didn't work.
Nice.
He's saying that didn't work because he knows what I'm doing anyway.
Still, make your move. It's good, baby. Get off the rope.
So you can see he's giving me opportunity to turn him the way he's not locking up. He's giving me chances to practice what we've been working on. And because I'm so tense, because of the pressure, I'm not feeling it and I'm not doing it. Here he's showing how gripping behind the head, you can transition to the side of the neck. So you grip like normal. He's like, this is good. This is good. Then you can switch. So grab, then go to the outside and turn. If I'd stepped outside of his leg, that would have turned much better. You have to like go behind them a little bit. See how he turns?
That's beautiful. You feel that?
Yeah.
No, that you can do it.
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
So he's saying that when you lock on the outside like that, it's balanced, but then when you go all on one side and turn, the person you're holding has no balance. All right, so now we're starting to get a bit back into the getting into clinch instead of already clinching. I'm less wilty than I was yesterday, which is good. He's saying I'm slow. I said I'm thinking too much. So my hips are in, getting on my toes a little bit, but then once I put my ass back, my head gets ripped down.
Oh, wait.
I'm trying to keep his standing leg while he's kicking me. I missed like three times.
Hop, baby.
So I'm pretty much moving all in one direction. You can see he kind of like rotates around more. He's like, don't look like that. You look like an idiot. Do Muay Thai. It's like your grandma telling you to stand up straight. You gotta stand up straight. Look like you know what you're doing. He's proud of himself right there. I'm trying to do what he does and hit his leg when he comes down. There, he's using the shoulder technique, just pinching the shoulder, and he got me off really fast, and I kind of like lurched forward because my balance wasn't ready. And he hit my leg from yesterday. It's so swollen and sore.
Get out of the ropes, baby.
So I'm trying to get his leg.
Get out of the ropes, Sylvie. Out of the ropes.
That's how you knock people out with leg kicks, is you keep going after it. Especially when they show you that it hurts.
Out of the ropes.
See how his energy goes up and mine goes down? That's what you gotta train out. Jesus.
Out of the ropes, Sylvie. Out of the corner.
He kicked my hand.
Come on, baby.
So I'm staying in a little bit better. Gotta rock my hips in a bit. And you can see, even when I get something on him, he just immediately tags me back with something. It's gotta be that, like, you finish every move kind of energy.
Out of the corner, so.
Oh, I look awesome, yeah? He's like, why are you so scared?
Follow.
So even though I threw him on the ground, I looked defeated because I didn't follow him.
Out of the ropes, Sylvie. Out of the corner.
So his, he's gonna yell at me for this. He's like, you can't grab the leg every time because they kick you in the head. He's saying Pung Noi is like a bee stings you. So every time he hits my leg, he's saying that he's stinging me. His like mascot is a bee. He's like, you can grab the leg sometimes, but don't keep doing it. It's easy, because then I know you're gonna do it and I kick you in the head. I'm like, yeah, I knocked you down that time though. So, that was crazy painful, and I'm actually having a hard time standing up, and I couldn't help it. I started crying. It was really painful. And then he sees that I'm crying, And he starts making fun of me. He's like, she's already crying. So I'm just trying to work through it. So I need to be like jerking on him and moving, but my positions are a little better. My hips are in. But here I'm just stuck. He's like, do something. He has two students on the ropes that are like out of view. And so for the next 5 minutes, he's going to be talking shit about me crying while hitting me. So everything he's saying is about, like, if you want to play with the boys, you can't cry. And the boys are laughing. To be fair, I'm not still crying. Yeah! Take that. So my foot is between his legs. I gotta move that.
Off the rope.
He's like, are you gonna cry like a girl? You gonna cry like a girl? And then the guy from yesterday who was all excited about me is back. He's still talking shit about me crying. But he's clinching more so that my leg is not obliterated. Knee. Turn.
Move, baby, move. Move. Yeah.
I'm trying. He's like, are you gonna cry? He hit it again.
Move, baby, move.
I gotta get my hips back for those knees.
Very good. Strong. Good dog.
He's making fun of me for crying.
That was, were those your big brother tears, baby? What?
So this is my small break. Is while he's chatting with these guys, I get like a minute. All right, so he got the pads and had me put on gloves just to do a little bit of pad work. He said, "Don't kick him because it's gonna hurt him." I think he actually just did this to show me off to the students and the guy who came in. Because our lessons are about clinch, but I was kind of punching him anyway, so maybe he just wanted to build my confidence back up after getting my ass kicked. So this is really good. He wants me to hook off of the incoming long knee or kick. So he's doing kind of the same things over and over, but I'm staying within distance where you can throw these and then come in for the clinch. So this is actually keeping me closer than I had been when getting my legs nailed, when we were trying to do the clinch. So they're arranging for someone to come, and he's like, just tell him to call first. This guy, these two guys, like, lounging around on the ropes, they live at the gym right now. So here he's showing me on the long knee, you hook as you move. When he demonstrates it, he's hitting behind my ear, like that would knock you out so good. He's like, Ramon Decker was good at this. I told him I'm gonna get the Ramon Decker haircut. So I think really this is just trying to get my confidence back up after our clinching. It's good because probably similar to... So, right there, I threw these elbows on him that I learned from Hippie. And just now, he was shocked because he didn't call for it. So he said, I'll make you cry again. Like, don't you throw those elbows at me. I'll make you cry again. But, as a result, he started working elbows with me. So... It's mostly just spacing and power. It's like when you get your legs bashed, you kind of get this adrenaline peak that I guess is a little bit like how after a guy gets nailed in the nuts and he gets all aggro.
A Loma's knee is that, baby.
So he's saying you can punch the stomach while they're kicking as well. So not only that hook,
use that knee,
but punch the body while someone's kicking or kneeing. Saying nen, like he wants me to be more accurate, like sharper on my punches. His pad work feels really good. I did pad work with him when I did my private session for Knock Muay Nation. But we haven't done it a lot together, but it's really sharp. It's very nice pad work. So he thought that the timer was going the whole time and it wasn't. So he's like, oh, we'll just do 9 more minutes. Then he makes fun of his student. He's like, my student does 1 round and then takes 2 rounds off. Those elbows are so fun. Like, you can just keep changing them, but just keep throwing elbows. It feels so nice. Keep your guard up, though. So he wants my head to come off center a little bit, like kind of drag it out to the side so that it's really, really straight. Rambaa spent many years in Japan, and so he has really good variety in the skills and the different training that he does, but he insists that all skills come from the same technique. Like, you don't change the technique a lot, even though they're very different strikes. And I think he's right. There's like this fundamental element to everything of how you get power out of things, and it all comes from your core. So here he's showing different elbows, and he says they're all the same technique. That last one is crazy, and I've never seen it before. He's showing how you use it in context. So when someone is kneeing you, see how it comes like from the outside in? So he's like, yeah, you can go straight up, no problem. You can come over like that. Or you can just do this crazy bell ringing elbow. He's like, you can do all of them, it's no problem. But this one is crazy. It looks like he's hitting with the inside of his elbow, but he is getting with the tip. He's like, Muay Thai has so many techniques. You can do all these different things. He's like, teachers will all teach you different things, but they're all similar. And they're all good. So he let me mess around with the different elbows for a while, and then he, for that one that he just taught me with that crazy coming in, he says, put your glove on your head. So I wasn't getting really good power on it until I put it on my head. So he's saying this is like a 1-2, like jab cross. So your left hand parries down, and then your right elbow comes over with that crazy ass. I don't even know what to call it. It's like a whip. It's almost like pistol whipping, yeah? Like it like comes from the side. So I had a hard time with it on the left. And he's saying that as someone's coming in, you can throw that. He's like, it's the same as the hook. He's like, it's the same technique. I'm telling Kevin he should feel them. So now he's saying, switch it up, do all kinds of different elbows off of the same thing to see how it's the same technique. You can just go between them, whatever you feel. And then when you're doing the opposite side, so when you're doing your left, you're still going to parry with your left. This very old lady came up with her cell phone and handed it to him to talk to somebody. I think they were trying to like book a room at a hotel or something. So skip the phone call. Here he had told me now to put... He's showing how it comes from the shoulder. And he's saying that you keep... Japhua means grab your head. So you keep your hand on your head. Your guard doesn't open. You just kind of like butterfly it. And that increased my power a lot. Just doing that. And you're safer. You can see the turn in the shoulder and the hip there. So he's like, you can do it while someone is hitting you, which is nasty. Oh, this elbow's so cool. He said that he came up with this elbow because he's a Muay Cow fighter, but he's short.
You follow it in.
So he liked to elbow like this while people were kneeing him. He's like, techniques are only slightly different. It's all the same. So you can switch between elbows without changing much. You don't have to think, like, which elbow am I going to throw now? You just move the angle a little bit. That elbow's so crazy. He says you can see him knocking people out on YouTube from his old Muay Thai fights using that elbow. Wait. He's like, you don't have to do it super powerful. It's more important to do it fast.
Fast cuts better than strong.
Mm.
I want to throw like 30 of those in a fight. It'd be so cool. Look just like this. So you block and then elbow from the block. Because you know they're open. See how their arm is caught on you? Bah! So he's like, even if you have your arm out, and when my hand is on his head, I can hold his head and elbow into it.
He's short, and the Muay Thai, he came up with it.
I fight Muay Thai,
So he's like, look on YouTube, you can see me doing this elbow. We asked him where he learned it, and he's like, no, I thought of it, because I'm short.
He know, you know, learn from someone? Tell, nobody teach you?
I'm like, you came up with this on your own? He's like, yeah, I thought of it. He's like, my crew taught me all of these different elbows. Like, there are so many elbows, but because I'm short, I like this one.
He made this elbow.
Yeah. He said his teachers taught him all the normal ones, but he likes the fob because it's when people are kneeing.
Duuglas-Ittu means short. He's like, I'm short, so I don't like when people knee. That'll stop you from kneeing.
First to the thigh, then to the...
He's like, there are many videos of me doing this. You can see it. He's like, you can look on YouTube.
Where do you hit? Where? Chin?
So if he fought someone my size, which he never did, you can get someone like in the eye or eyebrow, but because he was shorter, he was hitting people in the jaw a lot. But so I'm saying that because you frame your arms out for the clinch, that's brilliant to come in that way. Oh, look at how he does it so tight.
You ever see anyone? Ask him if you see anyone do this. Only Rambaa?
So we're asking him if anyone else has done this. Has he ever seen anyone else do it? And he's like, no, not really. He's like, I taught it to people, but they don't do it. Which makes me want to do it even more. He said, he's saying as fighters, you have to come up with your own stuff.